So our team is going to be going to warm up. Moms and dads, you've got a very hard job this afternoon. There's going to be a lot of sore throats to combat that lot. Let's hear it again for Horizon Community College. Come on! Yeah! There we go! And I've just been told on good authority that I shouldn't be calling you Sam Peters. I've just been told on good authority that you're apparently the Green Army? Absolutely amazing. Come on, let's hear it from both our sides so they can hear you in the changing room. One more time. Hawthorns, let's hear! And the best thing about this, whether you're a parent, your partner can't tie you off for making too much noise, and if you're a kid, the teachers can't tie you off for making too much either! Hawthorns, please welcome onto the pitch your finalists in the under-14 PlayStation FC Elite Schools Cup National Final, St. Peter's Catholic High School and Horizon Community College. Your lineup for St. Peter's Catholic High School at 1, Mamadou Diallo. At 2, Josh Kennedy. At 3, Joe Dowdeswell. At 4, Junior Kaposoa. At 5,
this is the under-14 PlayStation FC Elite Schools Cup National Final between Horizon Community College of Barnsley and St. Peter's Catholic High School of Gloucestershire. Running through the two starting 11s with Horizon Community College first. Ben Geary, Charlie Gledhall Carr, George Bedford, Liam McNulty, Logan Yule to captain, Taylor Parkin, Ewan Cutler, Luke Broadhurst, Jack White, Jake Scargill, and Bladen Heritage. Your starting 11 for Horizon Community College. For St. Peter's, Mamadou Diallo, Josh Kennedy, Joe Dodeswell, Junior. Archie Mowen, Junior Wilson, Archie Myatt, Woody Burgess, Obieri number 9, Max Jenner 10, and Adams number 11. And your substitutes, look out for your favourites, wherever you may be from, Horizon or St. Peter's. Horizon Community College in green and white with black shorts, St. Peter's in the yellow and green shorts. And I want to give credit actually to St. Peter's, it's delicious what they've done here. I think the whole school is here to support them. They have taken up at least 2 blocks of this main stand. If I was to guess how many, I reckon a good 700 have come here to support St. Peter's College. So they'll be the ones who will be very vocal. It really doesn't do it justice. That's just one part of the stand that they're taking up. They're taking up a second part of that as well. That's the left of our camera position. But Horizon Community College have good support as well. All around 40 to 50 fans. But they might be outsung today by the team from down the M5. Under-14s, 35 minutes each way. If we have a tie after 70 minutes, then this will be decided by the lottery penalty kicks. There is the Green Army, as they've called themselves. And I think they're coming on a number of busloads to get here to support their side. We're underway. Every pass, every cheer will be cheered on by this very partisan crowd below my commentary position. But it'll be up to Horizon Community College to try and silence them. That ball's gone 12 balls back, so someone's got to fish that one out. There's no ball boys here at the Hawthorns. Woo-hoo! this time will be added on at the end. As long as Jake Scargo can find the ball. Now it's great to see that the powers that be at St. Peter's Catholic High School, this is their second final, I believe. They brought 400 to a girls final at Stoke in recent time, and they thought as the under-14s were making this final in the boys division, they thought, well, let's bring the whole school up, or as much of many of them as possible to support. And I think it's absolutely delicious what the powers that be at St. Peter's High School, they should be commended for it. Here they are on the ball right now. Number 9, Obieri. Tagged by Ewan Cutler. Obieri going in. Turn on the sixpence. To try and send forward. Archie Myatt. Myatt. Into the box for the first attack of the game. Snuffed out by Liam McNulty. And the referee spots a foul. Referee, the man in the middle is Kyle Mowbray, I should say. It'll be assisted by Abdurrahman Shami and Daniel Toft on our line. Luke Broadhurst of Rotherham FC Academy. Junior Wilson just getting the ball away. Opportunity knocks here for number 12. Bladen Heritage. Heritage. Staying upright. Cutler. Free kick given to St. Peter's right. Wilson sends it downfield. Cutler. Horizon Community College in the five rounds when he scored 10 goals, and now St. Peter's are on the march. Good defender from Liam McNulty. Referee calling, saying no penalty for that one. Burgess. Obieri. Dick Scarlett just seeing the ball out of play. And St. Peter's, 28 goals scored, only 4 conceded in their 5 rounds on route to the final. Pulling 5 past Shrewsbury School, 8 past Torquay, 5 past Cardinal Newman Catholic School as well. They're not afraid to win the goals. And Charlie Gledhead Card as well. Horizon Community College in their 5 rounds, very much priding themselves on keeping it tight. Only 10 goals scored, 5 conceded though. A lot of close wins, a 2-1, a 1-0. 3-2, 2-2, so team that finds itself in keeping it tight. They haven't had it much the wrong way on route to this final, must be said. They did have a bye in round one. White Robinson College was a 2-1 victory. St. Aidan's, a 1-0. St. Bede's, a 3-2, and then went extra time against St. Francis Xavier's College. So they've done it the hard way getting to this final. No way. Good offload from Jack White. Scargo now on the chase. Good tackle from Marty Millward. Number of players, 3 players in fact, from St. Peter's School in the Academy of Cheltenham Town. Goalkeeper Diallo does well. Myatt, Obieri and Alfie Adams on the books at Cheltenham. Woody Burgess, the captain at Aston Villa. Max Jenner, just over the road actually, here at West Bromwich Albion. And Junior Wilson is currently on trial at Aston Villa. Taylor Parkin of Horizon Community College. Notable mentions for the five players who are at academies for Horizon Community College. Taylor Parkin to Sheffield United. Ewan Cutler and Jack White both at Barnsley. With Broadhurst at Rotherham, as is Charlie Redfern, the substitute, also at Rome. Battle there between Jenner and Parkin. And a reminder, if you're joining us for the first time, you get to choose the winner of the Player of the Match award. That'll be done by a Twitter poll. Halfway through the second half. Four players, it'll be two from each side, will be nominated. And it'll be up to you to decide the winner. Follow ESFA on Twitter at Schools Football. All one word, at Schools Football. And that poll will be up about 15 minutes before the end of the game. Headers and volleys in midfield at the moment. As now Horizon look to come forward to Scargo. Scargo with a little bit of room. Pass it forward and an opportunity. Great save from Diallo, from Jack White. Heritage on the far side, dispossessed by Josh Kennedy. They win the throw in. Superb save from Diallo. To stop the shot from Jack White. Great pass from Scargo, first of all, to find White, who hit it in his path. And Diallo collects. 9 minutes down, no score. Obieri, Jenner, and Adams asking for it. Playing the football from Jethro Carr. Martin Norwood at the second time asking. Plays it away. So Josh Kennedy. Kennedy chips it forward to Myatt. Myatt. Well, and still with possession, and the opportunity comes, and it's over the bar. Alfie Adams was asking for it. Obieri thought he had the confidence to take it on his left boot. Guildhead chance for St. Peter's to open that account. Thank you. Matty Millwood, centre of the forward. Battle number 8, won by Woody Burgess. Junior Wilson. On the bounce. Pessoa. Wins the free kick. Too quickly for our referee's liking. Adams with the opportunity on the scoring. Good save by Ben Gooley in the Horizon 6. Well, so Peters are the ones playing with confidence right now, and they're off to the races once more. Myatt. And this is the first time of asking, how's the second time? Cross out of play. Ball kick, Horizon. Eden Heritage leading the field after just 12 minutes. Charlie Redfern coming on. Great opportunity it was for Adams, but a good save from the Horizon goalkeeper to keep this at 0-0. Both sides show an endeavour. Two good saves we've seen so far from Geary and Diallo in between the sticks. And the push in the back has given the foul. And taken by Tyler Park. To the mixer, it's a good ball, it's a great ball, and to the score. Logan Yord, nearly on the receiving end of a Hail Mary pass. And you've sensed realistically anything on target, it's in the back of the net. Yold. Horizon. Come forward. Drop chance. Save. Kept out. Gotta be. In. Jack White, the scorer. The other couldn't keep this one out. Jack White makes up from the great save Diallo got from his shot earlier in the game. But it's the player on Barnsley's books who opened the scoring in this under-14s final. listen to St. Peter's respond. They win a free kick from the kickoff. Gemma looking to put this one in to the box. Doesn't get past the first man, but it's come out loose. Wilson's there. Pessoa. Myatt using his pace. Wins the corner. Well, that's it. Looking up past Will. Dangerous ball. Corner. Halfway through the first half, Jack White's goal separates the two. Broadhurst. Peters in the back. Adams on the chase. And Adams under pressure here from Greg O'Carr. He does well. Does very well, in fact. 17 Peters, you've got to start again. Adams. Millwood. Back to Wilson. To start. And he can set a goal to the long ball for Obiedi to chase. Who's first up with the number 9 but gets second prize in the corner. A very popular teacher at St. Peter's, getting a rueful cheer from the crowd. Centre field from Melty. Solid to chase. Wilson does well. Dodwell. Back to Diallo in the goal. And ball forward. Woody Burgess. White, the goal scorer. Chips forward to Skaga. Skaga. Looking for help, and he finds Junior Wilson, who relieves the danger and tells Horizon, start again from your own half. Parker. Scargo. And he is Jack White, but Wilson is there to relieve the danger. Ball's gone out of play. Chip for Alfie Adams. 20 minutes gone. Still Horizon lead by a goal to nil. Heavy tackle from Millwood. On Broadhurst. Paul Diallo in trouble again. Well, it seems that Horizon have got the number on St. Peter's on the set piece. Be careful on that one. That's the start stages of this game. Pessoa, Wilson, long ball forward, Maya at the target, not found, Wilson again, as another back to the chair, Robbie Kendrew takes the throw inside the Horizon half. Support, reinforcements, commits the foul. And our referee Kyle Mulray just going to give the St. Peter's number 9 a little bit of a telling off. With 12 minutes left to go in this first half. Wilson on the volley. Adams collects. The pressure with two clean sheets around him. Maniniello's got to dance his money away, but wins a throw. Stopped out by Josh Kennedy. Kennedy, sending through to Obieri. Obieri goes down, but the flag is a flop side. Yield. Obieri. Adams in the chase. Obieri. Wins that particular battle. 10 minutes left to go as this ball slicing away. Is collected by Jake Scott. Jack White. Scarborough. Broadhurst. Redhill Carr. Sending this one forward. For Redfern. And Horizon win the free kick. Parking. Again in the mixer. Had a Scargill. Not goalward, so out for the goal kick. We have just around under 10 minutes to go in this first half. On a play. Only one goal separating these two sides. One way to go. Time for St. Peter's to build the platform here. Christian Oliver coming onto the field for Alfie Adams. Burgess. Abiyadi into the box. Trying to go along, but he's got the army of green shirts around him. Now finds the offload. The number 10, Max Jenner. Still with the team in yellow. Jenner. Woody Burgess. Sola, Wilson. Awesome. into the box, dispossessed, picked up by Oliver. This is Skargo. Header from Wilson. Wilson pops it away. He's picked up by Kennedy. Kennedy. Tony Knight chase this. Free kick. Given to St. Peter's. Max Jenner will be swinging this one in. Jenner swinging it in, up the back post. Chatter Wilson! Just missing out. Coming onto the field. For the goal scorer, Jack White, who will have a 10-15 minute rest before no doubt returning. Penalty. Redford. This is Charlie Redford. Sorrow cuts it out. Kennedy will have to find a way to regain possession and does so. And the referee is calling him, believe it or not, for an offside. So St. Peter's will restart. Long way back. Much to the annoyance of some of the Horizon community fans, although we feel that decision is completely incorrect. Wilson. Burgess. Boss comes in. Albiero. Shoots. Chance again. Good save. From Oliver, shot by Gideon, the goal. Free kick. Better with a throw. Gailey comes out to clear, and in fact it's a fantastic pass to Heritage. Heritage returns. Redfern under pressure from Wilson. He's had a good game in this first half. Well spun by Max Jenner. Jenner is still going strong. From here for Archie Myers, good referee, and to see how well the play builds. There's a foul. So it will be Woody Burgess looking to put this one in. We're already taking quickly on too quickly for our referee's liking. So second back to the cherry for Burgess. Plenty of yellow shirts to target. One at the back post there with Millwood completely unmarked.
That's indeed the target, and Bill's Wilson's head over the bar. So there we go at the break. One goal separates the two sides. Jack White's goal. Just the difference at the break. It's under 14 PlayStation FC Elite Schools Cup National Final. Horizon Community College 1, St. Peter's Catholic High School 0. Save that was from Diallo to stop Jack White in the early part of this final. Albion just over the bar. Save as well. Morgan Yord. It's not there, but a moment ahead of offside here. Is the goal. Diallo tried so hard to keep the ball out, but Jack White was there to pick up the scraps. Well, it was his shot that hit the post. Only right that he claimed the rebound. To give Horizon Community College a 1-0 lead. Obieri. And then it was a good save from Geary in the goal to stop Christian Oliver. So that's where we are at the break. We'll be back in a few more minutes for the second half. And at half time, it is Horizon Community College of Barnsley leading St. Peter's Catholic High School of Gloucester by a goal to nil.
Inside the last project, I'm going to be able to do this. But no, back to the camera, and the first time,
PlayStation FC Schools Cup 2022 has seen over 4,800 teams taking part, with almost 18,000 players registered to play as well. It's all come down to this, the finals. What's he got?
So here we go for the next bit of drama.
Away we go. St. Peter's Catholic High School in yellow, going from left to right in the second half. Trailing by a goal to nil, just to remind you, later in this half, around about 20 minutes or so from now, there'll be a poll open on Twitter, at Schools Football, for your player of the match. You fall on these two from each side, and you'll get to decide the winner. Plenty more drama to come, plenty more chances for one of these four players on the field. To put away their nominations, and that was a late charge. Just wide from Archie Millwall. It was a great ball. Possessed by Cutler. Tommy Scargo will chase this, but there is a chance here for Scargo. He could be making 2-0 and has done. Was a mistake at the back. And Jack Scargo was there to pounce. I'm enjoying the celebrations. Up at the back between Millwood and Diallo, I think, has gifted Jake Scargo a second for Horizon Community College. Indeed, that is the case. It was off Diallo, in fact, for Scargo, and he was there to pounce 2-0. And now St. Peter's with a mountain to climb. Burgess, dispossessed. Chips forward. Baden headed to Chess. There's a flag up on the far side. Closer than where I am in the commentary box. He's given a goal kick.
Should have been a corner.
My 38-year-old eyes aren't deceiving me just yet. Matt. Foul for the pull. Attacking opportunity coming here for St. Peter's. Coming in, it's going to be too high from Jenna. Suddenly keep it to get on with it. I think that may be the last time he'd be allowed to do that, otherwise it could be in the referee's mud pit. Wilson. Burgess. Vieri. Pass though from the number 9. Parking. Vieri misses out on that occasion, and Max Scherzberg will remain strong. Picked up by Pessoa. Jenner wins the foul. It's going to be a foul. Crowd are cheering, but I think it was quite obvious and evidence that was never going to be given in a million planets, it must be said. The foul on the goalkeeper. Let's have a look again. The looping header. This is having a good game for St. Peter's. Jenner. Attacking platform on their way for St. Peter's. Burgess with the ball in hand. 6 of Vieri. Who seems to be the target for the Horizon defence to make sure he doesn't get a shot away. And Gurley taking the leaf out of the Jordan Pickford block. Going to ground and eating up a little bit more time. Burgess. Okay. Well, some of the crowd thought that there was a penalty in coming, but on this occasion, St. Peter's trying to get back into the game there. Beginning to put the Horizon Community College defence under a bit of pressure, but they're hoping to pop in, but they cannot blow this hands down right now. Naughty. And the swing and a miss. Myatt. Pessoa. Chats. Should be a goal. Should be a goal. It's a goal. Woody Burgess. Has got St. Peter's back in the tie. Two one. And we still have plenty of time. Is receiving some treatment, and we also love the crowd coming in for Junior Wilson. Remind you, about 5 or 7 minutes from now, there'll be a poll open on Twitter for your player of the match. And these will be sent forward very shortly for that one. I'll give you a nod as to when to go on to at Schools Football on Twitter for your player of the match. There'll be two players on each side. From Burgess. Get round Geary. 2-1 the score as Raymond Nolte is the one who's receiving some treatment right now. Substitution being made. The forward first returning. And Liam McNulty will be the passing pitch. Receiving a knock. So Peter's the ones with their tails up. Twenty minutes left to go. Burgess. Dispossessed.
wins the corner. Millard and Wilson going forward. The crowd right behind the St. Peter's team. Burgess in the mixer once again. Does well. Jenner tries to get the shot away. And to Burgess. Needs support and looking to find help at the back post. Straight into the arms of Gary. On the far side, so it will be a high horizon throw. Launches it upfield. At the early attacked. And number nine as well. Ball lost out in midfield. Kennedy. Just possessed by Redford. Resolute defending though from St. Peter's. Chance, just wide. Burgess, back to Wilson. Good skills from the number six. Have to go. Awesome. Sending it forward. To St. Peter's. Broadhurst. Jack wins the free kick.
Jenner. Spins away and makes his way into the 18-yard box. Jenner still going to be a shot away. Jenner wide in the post. To go, the poll is live for your player of the match. Two from Horizon Community College, two from St. Peter's. The nominees are Jack White of Horizon's got the first goal, Jake Scargill has got the second, Junior Wilson of St. Peter's, and Woody Burgess of St. Peter's. They are your four nominees. Jenner. Chips it back into play. 18-yard box. Opportunity coming. And then it goes down, no penalty. Doldrum. Hoofed upfield by Landon Austin. Wilson. Spots Josh Kennedy. Kennedy back into midfield, but picked up by Austin. Austin, too much of a heavy pass. And Millwood will be there to start again for St. Peter's. At Schools Football on Twitter is where you need to go. At Schools Football, if you want to watch your vote for the player of the match. This is Myatt. And the pressure from Darnborough. Myatt does well. Gets inside the 18-yard box. Opportunity coming in! It's a goal! That's Jenner! Equalizer for St. Peter's! Jenner the scorer, level game with 12 minutes to go. But it must be said, that all came from Archie Myatt on the right hand side. Great skill from the young number 7. Came off the knee of Jenner, he won't care, it's in the back of the net. 2-2, 12 minutes left. This game now is in the balance. And it could be in here. Scarborough, that's a superb tackle. Good scoring, good vision from Abieri, but the final part of the pass, that's what we desired for the number 9. Woody Burgess, the different team, the second half, this St. Peter's side. They'll be full of confidence since they've gone 2-0 down. They're more prepared. Wilson is there to collect, as is Millwood. but now they could be in trouble. Counter-attack is diminished. Obieri. Two players on him, but Obieri needs to find space to get a shot away, and he hasn't had the opportunity to do that in the first 60 minutes or so. He hasn't been given much space by the Horizon Community College defence. To their credit, and they're off, and well, they could be a 3-on-1 here, they could be in trouble. There's an opportunity coming in! Roll for Bladen Heritage over the bar. The easy pass was next to him, to Scargill. Could have left it for Scargill and he would have been open. He's still going to have plenty of time here. There's been a lot of stoppages in this game, so expect at least 3 or 4 minutes. Stoppage time to be there. He said he could have left this, could have left it run. Or even got the pass over to Scargill, who was there open at the back post. While we have a stoppage in play, remind you, at Schools Football on Twitter, to register the vote for the player of the match. Jack White, Jake Scargill, Junior Wilson, Woody Burgess. They are the four to vote for. The winner will receive a nice memento from the ESFA and from PlayStation. At Schools Football on Twitter is where you need to go. Plenty of you have voted already, which is great to see. And that vote closes in 8 minutes at the 70-minute mark. So get on Twitter now and register your vote. Gives us all a chance for a breather. Jimmy Wilson just continues to receive some treatment. He's up on his feet now, though. Flags are draped, they're ready to go for the St. Peter's Brigade below. Eight minutes to go for stoppage time, plenty of time for a winner. No. Myatt. He's grown in confidence as the game's gone on. I'm very impressed with Archie Myatt in the second half. He's had a very good game. Ball goes out of play. And it's all going for the team in yellow right now. Burgess. Referee's calling for a foul here. And he's calling the linesman's calling the referee over. Free kick. Just on the line of the 18-yard box. So we're in the chance here for Woody Burgess. 2-0 down, remind you, St. Peter's Catholic High School. Burgess is going to relent and let Max Jenner take this one instead. Jenner, Burgess, open. Has it go himself? Burgess, over the bar. Clever football from St. Peter's. The training ground routine. Yuld. Broadhurst. Scargill. park. Wilson, no nonsense. With the throw. Pushing the back on Wilson. Free kick, and Wilson's telling his team, get forward. On the bounce, picked up by Jack White, the first goal scorer. White, finding some room. Scargo, opportunity, goal, 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 offside, offside, on the far side. St. Peter's breathe again. Not going to be by much. It would not have been by much for Heritage. Started his run too early. Wilson. 3.5 minutes left to go. Reminder, if this finishes this level, we go straight to a penalty shootout. Albieri. Trying to use his strength. 9-on-9, does well. So I just got her car. Free kick given to Horizon. 3 minutes left to go, plus stoppage time. 3 minutes left on our Twitter poll for the player of the match. At school football is where you need to go to register your vote. Jack White, Jake Scargill, Junior Wilson, Woody Burgess are the four nominees for the player of the match. A reminder, the winner receives a silver salver from the ESFA and also nice momentum from PlayStation. Scargo looking to chase. No penalty from our referee, Carl Mulder. A great little run. A super darting run, Myers. Was after it, and it had to be put into the stands by Ewan Cutler. Albieri. Jack Scott was hobbling. So we're going to have plenty of time for stoppages as well. At least a couple of minutes for the stoppage time. Kennedy. Picked up by Gladwell Carr. Forward to Heritage. White. Won't be there. Goal kick. Likelihood is now, with a minute to go, it's going to be a buzzer beater for one of these sides. Or it's going to go down to the lottery of penalties. Max Heseltine due to come onto the field. Zach Taylor coming on the field for Joe Dodeswell. Burgess, Wilson, Time's in the red, so we're going to have stoppages at the fourth official. Mo Hassan racking up the number right now. Parkin. It's only 3 minutes of stoppage time. Chance. Good save from Viallo. Had to recover. Twitter cut poll is now shut for the player of the match. Thank you for all your votes. Free kick going St. Petersburg. Congratulations to Jake Scarton, who receives the player of the match. Voted for you by our illustrious panel on Twitter. Thank you very much. Jake receiving 47% of the vote. Last hurrah. Jenner into the box. Keeper under pressure. Goes through all of them. There will have been an opportunity. And there's a golden opportunity. Burgess needs help. They get help. Burgess again trying to slide it in for Obi Eddie. Could it be Horizon who'll have the last laugh here? Parkin. There's over 60 seconds left to go. St. Peter's won't have the throw. Wilson. Ball in upfield. Burgess. Back for clears. Norwood hooks it backwards. Vieri. Burgess. And Vieri. There's not much space in this game. Spots Burgess, but he's offside. Another substitution looks like it should be made, indeed. The 14 London Austin returns to the field. Max Heseltine leaving. And that is the end of regulation time. So, this game is going to be decided with the lottery of penalty kicks. Sides will huddle and it'll now be time for the goalkeepers to try and become heroes.
Thank you.
Choose an end. The penalty has been taken towards the Smethwick end here at the Hawthorns, so it's just a decision of who's going to go first. So Horizon won the toss, and they will go first. So here we go. Down to the lottery of penalty kicks. Both keepers are wet and waiting. The first player has come from Horizon Community College. And it's going to be Tyler Parkin, who takes the longest walk in football. So Parkin against Diallo. First penalty in the shootout. Scores. Albieri. Sledging. I think both keepers are trying to use mind games. Albieri to level up. Come on. Charlie Redfern. And the next one up. The penalty from Obiadi to level this game. The penalty shootout up, one apiece. Redfern. Good penalty. Excellent second penalty for Horizon Community College, 2-1 in the shootout. Around the left side of the goal. Excellent penalty this one. Yeah, you don't stop that one. Archie Myatt, who helps them set up the second goal for St. Peter's. Wasting no time. Wasted a lot of time, didn't Myatt there? I think the referee took this one whilst Myatt was on his runner. Level game, 2-2. Right down the middle. Jack White scored the first goal in this final. Now has the third penalty. As we are level, two penalties apiece. White, just about. Well, I think he scuffed it. It was a bit of a fluff, but rolled in all the same. 3-2. Let's take a look at this one again. I think he may have just hit the top of the ball here. It wasn't perfection, but it's at the back of the net nonetheless. 3-2. Max Jenner. Jenner. 3-3. Bladen Heritage now with the fourth penalty. Just about. The other went the right way. Couldn't keep it out. Perfection so far. Just got a little hand to it, didn't he? Burgess. The captain. This to level the shootout. Over the bar. So it all comes down. This could be won right now. Charlie Gledhill Carr can be the hero for Horizon Community College. Gledhill Carr, Horizon for victory. Yes, it is! Horizon Community College take this trophy, take the final on a penalty shootout by 5-3. Perfection in the penalty shootout. Charlie Gledhill Carr, the hero. They take it by 5-3. And it finishes 2-2 in regulation. Time ago, these are the highlights as celebrations continue to be made out in the middle. First goal from Jack White. Second goal from Jake Scargill to make it 2-0. Silence in the crowd, but they came back into life through Woody Burgess. They've got him back into the game. The equaliser from Max Jenner to make it 2-2. So the game is a great opportunity right at the death. It's trying to win this game in regulation time. But it was Woody Burgess who scored the first for St. Peter's. But then it came down to Charlie Cledhook-Carr to score the winning penalty for Horizon Community College, who are the winners of the under-14 PlayStation FC Elite Schools Cup National Final. So our officials collecting their mementos. Jake Scargill receiving the reward as the player of the match. Gets that beautiful memento. And also a little gift from PlayStation as well. Catholic High School came here with an army in the stands, but it didn't let them down. Took this game all the way from 2-0 down. Just losing out on a penalty shootout. A volley attack. College from Yorkshire will now have to receive the gold medals as winners of the under-14 PlayStation FC Elite Schools Cup national winners. So it'll be down to Logan Yule. To receive the last medal and, more importantly, the trophy.
So proud of your boys this afternoon.
I'm super proud of the boys. They have come back, got down. They've been great. I knew it wasn't to be on the day. No one wants to go to play. It's a horrible way to be. But
absolutely, it is the lottery of penalties, unfortunately, but your boys and the whole of your school, such a great representation of Gloucestershire this afternoon.
Yeah, they're brilliant. Thanks, a massive credit to our school, so many people. Thanks for honouring them as well, didn't everything, but you know, we did the same with the girls. Fantastic, a green army on tour.
Well, I think it's only right that one more time we hear it for the Green Army. So I'm here with Coach Copley. What a final between these two sides.
A bit of a nail-biter. I'd like to just first of all say what a performance from St Peter's. Well-backed as well. It's what school football should be about. So I think when it goes to penalties, there's a winner and a loser, but I really don't believe that. I was probably more relaxed during the penalties than I was in the game, because ultimately it's a lottery. So I'd just like to put a big shout out to St Peter's, and hopefully we'll play them again for the game.
I think there's what you said, absolutely key. This is what schools football is all about, a fantastic advert from both sides.
A- Absolutely. I think there's boys on the field who don't play professional clubs. And if professional clubs are in the stands, which I'm sure they are, the names are all being taken down, and I'm sure there's some phone calls and some opportunities for them. To my team, when I got them in year seven, I always believed I'd got a high quality team, and it's proved that they've gone quite a long way. In year seven, they got to the semi final of the Nationals. There was nothing in year eight due to COVID. But in year nine, we got to the other semi final. We were lucky to lose in the last minute of extra time. It could have been 2 in 3 days, but we've stuck at it today. We've not played particularly well. I think that's that, but I also win as a grid. So we've done what we needed to do. And we've got there, we've held his nerve. I'd like to pick Archie Ryan's not with us today. He's sat on a beach in Tenerife. It's a wedding, I believe. But Archie gives us another dimension as well. So big shout out to Archie. We are thinking about you, but we brought the cup home for you.
And you must be so proud. It was arguably an away game for you guys, but you had that mental strength to power through and get the win in the end. You must be so proud of your team.
Absolutely. We talked about it before we went out that we, in effect, we were the away team, but ultimately the game's played on a field, 11v11, just to try and silence it. We slowed it down in the first half a little bit. Made quite a lot of substitutions just to try and get us a little bit of a foot in the game, and it worked to a degree. One last thank you. I'd like to thank his leadership team who have come down today and have spoiled us a little bit on the bus. Just hopefully the spirits on the bus are all right. I'm sure it'll be interesting on the bus on the way back.
Well, coach, congratulations. I'm going to let you celebrate with your team. One more time, let's hear it for Horizon Community College. There you have it, more finals to come from the PlayStation FC Schools Cup 2022.